Yaniv Gabay here with Gabay Real Estate Professionals, and today we're going to talk about the best way to purchase a property in Israel. We broke it down to four very easy steps for you. We're going to go through them right now. The first step is what your budget is. How much money do you want to allocate to a property? Every agent asks buyers when they call. That's something that some buyers don't like to disclose right away, but it's important to know that so that we know what property to take you to. But you first need to get a good handle on what your budget is. In order to get the handle on that, you really need to know what your costs are. So we're going to talk a little bit about the closing costs. Number two, features and location. What exactly do you want to buy? Okay, what property, in what location, etc. Number three, my personal favorite, choosing an agent and negotiating on the property. And then number four, what is the closing process and how to choose an attorney. Okay, each segment we're going to dedicate to a different video, so we hope that you stay tuned and watch those as well. So let's get into the actual closing costs. So the closing costs are as follows. You have three basic closing costs: attorney's fee, agent's fee, and purchase tax. There are additional costs such as registering the property. You're going to have to spend a little bit of money on that. You're going to have to put a little bit of money into just or figuring in the cost of exchanging the money if you're purchasing with dollars. And a lot of you actually do well by taking a mortgage broker, which also obviously charges for his or her services. But we're going to chalk that all up to 1%. So let's just add 1% in addition to the attorney's fee, agent's fee, and purchase tax that we're about to disclose right now. So the attorney's fee. Attorneys, obviously, different attorneys take a different fee. I would say the vast majority of them, at least in Jerusalem, take 1% plus VAT. In the fourth video, we'll get a bit into how to choose an attorney and what the contractual process is all about. So stay tuned for that. If you purchase a first-hand apartment, meaning either pre-construction or you're purchasing a property that is already built, but you'll be the first one that owns that property, okay, therefore first-hand, you will be paying up until approximately 1.5% plus VAT. That's an important factor to consider. Why? The way the structure here works, or the contractors will take an attorney to register the property in the buyer's name. And what they do is they don't take a fee from the contractor, they take the fee from the buyers. So in addition to the attorney that you're going to have to pay to represent you in the contract, you're gonna also have to pay on a first-hand apartment an attorney to register the property in your name, and that's pretty much across the board. I know they tried to put in a law to change that, but as of today, that's pretty much across the board in every first-hand apartment that you're going to purchase. Okay, so that's an attorney's fee. Agent's fee, very straightforward, 2% plus VAT. Are there agents that go down? There are. We're going to talk about that in the agent's video. And an agent is really there to represent your interests. The more you disclose to that agent, the more that agent can help you. As far as using a real estate agent, most transactions, especially in Jerusalem, are done with a real estate agent, so chances are you're going to have to pay that 2% plus VAT. Both buyers and sellers here pay that amount, pay the 2%, so that's approximately how we break it down. 1% for an attorney, 2% for the agent, and now to the purchase tax. Purchase tax, we break it down into two different categories. The first category, you're talking about a straightforward local buyer who does not own another property in their name. Okay, that local buyer has a much bigger break on the purchase tax. It goes by scale. The scale goes as follows. Up until $1.5 million, there is no purchase tax. So if by some crazy chance a local buyer was able to find an apartment in Jerusalem for under $1.5 million, then they also get to enjoy the benefit of not paying a purchase tax. From a little over 1.5 to 1.8, you're talking already 3.5%. From 1.8 to 4.6, that's 5%. And then from 4.6 to 15 million shekel, you're talking about 8%. You saved up all that money, you know, paid taxes your whole life, and now you're paying another tax with that money you saved buying an apartment. Okay, foreign buyers or investors, up until $1,000,001, you are paying 5%. So from the bat, from the first shekel you're spending on an apartment, you're paying a 5% purchase tax. From 1.1 to 3.3, that number goes up to 6%. Again, that is on the relative difference. It's not like if you bought a 2 million or 2.5 million shekel apartment, on the total sum you're paying 6%. It's on the difference. It's every shekel above 1.1 and until 3.3, on that portion you're paying 6%. That's an important clarification there. From 3.3 to 4.6, you're at 7%. From 4.6 to 15 million, you're paying 8%. Again, we chalked up the registration, the mortgage exchange, all 1%, a little bit more, a little bit less, depending on, you know, the specific property and more like the specific buyer. We're really talking about when it comes down to purchasing an $1 million apartment here, you're talking about an average of 7 to 10% closing costs. Remember, that sum is due on signing. So if you come in to a situation where you're looking to buy an apartment, you have $1 million, you should be looking at $900,000 apartments, or you should try to get a good enough agent that can negotiate the $1 million apartments down to $900,000, because you're gonna have $100,000 just in closing costs, and that is due in signing. That's also important distinction when you are negotiating how much you're putting down on the property. So if on signing, you're gonna be putting in 15% on signing, it's really 25%. I hope that this was helpful. For more information on real estate in Jerusalem and on specific properties, I would love to help you find the perfect property here in Israel. Call me, 052-614-1442. You can also email me at yaniv@gabayrealestate.com, or just feel free to check out our website, www.gabayrealestate.com. Thank you so much, and check out some of our other videos. Have a great day.